This time, ChargerLab got a 3-in-1 GaN charger from Anker. It comes with a USB-A to USB-C ports and foldable prongs, and it can support a charging power of up to 65 watts even in its small size. To know how it does that, let's take it apart to see the internal components. The Anker and Series 5 are printed on a box, and the back has specs info, which we'll talk about later. Let's take out the charger. The box contains the charger and some documents. Remove the protective film. The charger adopts a rounded case with a matte surface. The case is made of fire-retardant PC, and this size has the logo of Anker. The specs info are also printed on the input end. Model is A2332. It can support input of 100 to 240 volts, 50 or 60 Hz, 1.8 amp. The total output is 65 watts. It supports automatic power distribution and multi-port output at the same time. Here are the foldable prongs. The output panel adopts a translucent design, and it has a USB-A and two USB-C ports. They are all blue, and the USB-A has special pins. The size of it is about 67x39x30mm. It's much smaller than the Apple 61W charger. The weight is about 133 grams. ChargerLab PowerZ KM003C shows that the USB-C one supports FCP, SCP, AFC, QC 3.0, QC 4+, SFCP, PE 2.0, PD 3.0, PPS, DCP, and Apple 2.4 amp protocols. And it has 4 fixed PDOs of 5V, 9V, 15V, 3A, and 20V, 3.25 amp, and a set of PPS. The supported protocols of USB-C 2 are QC 3.0, QC 4+, SFCP, PE 2.0, PD 3.0, PPS, DCP, and Apple 2.4 amp protocols. And it has 4 fixed PDOs of 5V, 9V, 15V, 3A, and 20V, 3.25 amp, and a set of PPS. The USB-A supports AFC, QC 3.0, SFCP, PE 2.0, DCP, and Apple 2.4 amp protocols. Now, let's start to take it apart. Remove the input cover with a spudger and a hammer. The plugs are connected to the PCB module through wires, and the PCB module is filled with potting compound. Next, use a cutting machine to cut the remaining case. Take out the PCB module. There are thermal pipes placed inside the case. The PCB module is covered and filled with pink potting compound. The metal heatsink on the back is fixed with heat-resistant tape. Clean up the PCB module. There are fuse, common mode choke, transformer, capacitors, and back PCBs on the front. The master control chip, optocoupler, SMD back capacitor, and synchronous rectifier are on the back. ChargerLab found it adopts 2 independent back circuits with fixed output voltage. Next, we'll take a look at each component starting from the input end. The fuse is insulated by the white rubber cover. Take off the rubber cover. The fuse is from Better Fuse. 3.15 amp, 250 volts. The common mode choke is wound with magnet and insulated wires, and is also insulated with backlight. The safety X2 capacitor is from DGCX, 0.22 microfarad. The bridge rectifier is from Zawi, 1000 volts, 6 amp. These 4 electrolytic capacitors for input filtering are from CHNCAP. The total capacity is 108 microfarad, 27 microfarad, 400 volts for each. The differential mode choke is insulated by heat shrinkable tubing. Then, let's take a look at the primary side. The master control chip is from Dongke. It integrates the flyback controller and a GenFET, which is 650 volts, 260 mino. It can reduce losses and provide protection. The magnetic core of the transformer is insulated by tape. The blue wire capacitor is from DGCX. The SMD wire capacitor is from KFET. It is placed in the opening of the PCB to reduce thickness. The optocoupler is from Everlight and is used for output voltage feedback. Next, let's look at the synchronous rectification circuit. Its controller is from MPS. It can support a frequency of up to 600 kHz and multiple working modes. The synchronous rectifier is from HR Macro and adopts PDFN 5x6 package, 100 volts, 3.4 mm. The solid capacitor for output filtering is from CHNCAP, 25 volts, 560 microfarad. The output end has three small PCBs. There are buck PCBs of USB C1, C2, and USB-A. The inductor of USB C2 and USB-A is wrapped in heat shrinkable tubing. There are buck inductors and solid capacitors on the front. The solid capacitor for output filtering is insulated by tape. There are USB-C sockets and MOSFETs on the back. The buck controller is from S-Modware. It supports charging of any USB-C and USB-A ports and dual-port independent current limiting. The MOSFET used for secondary synchronous buck circuit is from S-Modware. The buck inductor is wound with wires. The solid capacitor for output filtering is from CHNCAP, 25 volts, 390 microfarad. The VBUS MOSFET is from VGSAMI and adopts PDFN3333 package, 30 volts, 5.2 mm. The USB C1 socket is blue. The buck controller of USB C2 and USB-A is from S-Modware. It is a highly integrated multi-protocol dual-port charging system on chip that supports charging of any USB-C and USB-A ports. It adopts QFN 4x4-32 package. The MOSFET used for secondary synchronous buck circuit is from S-Modware. The buck inductor is wound with magnet wires and insulated by heat shrinkable tubing. The specs of this solid capacitor for output filtering is 25 volts, 390 microfarad. The VBUS MOSFETs for USB C2 and USB-A are the same as that of the USB C1. The USB-A socket is insulated by black tape. Well, those are all components of the Anker 65W 3-in-1 GaN charger. It has a fire-retardant grounded case. Both USB-C ports can support up to 65W, and the USB-A port can also support fast charging. After taking it apart, we found it adopts two independent buck circuits to achieve 3-port fast charging. The PCB module is filled with pointing compound for heat dissipation. It is commendable that it can achieve a charging power of 65W in such a small size, and it even has 3 ports. Okay, that's all for today's video. Please drop a like, leave your comments, and subscribe to us. See you next time. Bye!